bottom right rib cage, the high kick there. He's tagged him again. Lee Kay wins on rubber legs. He may be right for the picking. Down he goes, and it's good night, Irene. Body shot Pikachu gets called.
Do you think you've done enough to earn a shot at the Bantamweight King, John Lineker?
What do you think? I'm pretty sure I did. I have more wins than he does in the World Championship now. I'm coming for you, John Chica Lineker. Don't hide. Don't hide. You are next.
Since making his one debut in 2020, Fabricio Wonderboy Andrade has become one of the most exciting young stars in MMA.
You know what is funny? I always knew I would fight for one. But it took a long time for that to happen. 5 years I was trying to get in here, and it happened on the COVID, you know.
We begin tonight with breaking news, 12,000 confirmed cases.
I was in Thailand, COVID was like going really bad, and then boom, I had the opportunity to fight in Bangkok against Mark, you know.
Mark Verdic Abelardo!
Nobody knew me, everybody thought I was lost, but the people who were training with me, the people who knew me, they knew like how confident I was, and then I said, I'm gonna finish this guy.
I knew I would make it look easy, you know. I needed to make a statement. I needed people to see how good I was, you know.
What does Andrade look to do from here, Dragon?
Oh, he defended beautifully, and he jumps on the back. The choke is under the chin. This might be a wrap, folks. It's tight. It's
Can
tight.
Can he find it? Can he find it? The Wonder Boy, figure four around the body. Abelardo with a hole in the bubble. It's good night, Irene! Abelardo's gone to sleep. Open the fridge. He is out cold. Fabricio Andrade, welcome to ONE Championship.
Growing up in poverty, the Brazilian phenom struggled to chase his dream of becoming a fighter on the global stage.
I'm from Fortaleza, is a city in the northeast of Brazil, and I come from like a very poor area. I started training when I was 13. I knew I would be a good fighter, I knew I could make it, but it was really hard to explain people when you are 13 and you are just starting, it's hard to explain that you're gonna do it, you know?
Despite his difficult financial situation, Wonderboy claimed multiple Muay Thai titles in Brazil by the age of 16.
When I was 19, I was going through a really difficult time again. And in Brazil at the time, I couldn't get any fights because it was really hard to get fights there. And was when I decided to move to China. I contacted with the guy there that was there. He said I could fight in China, I could make money. I went to fight like bigger promotions and started to make money. Then I went to Hong Kong. I met a Brazilian that has a gym there. For the first 3 months, I lived in the gym in Hong Kong, and I was just like teaching like privates to have like food money, you know. But then after a while, like I started to get fights again, and then people started to see me. I think it was like 2018. I went to Thailand to prepare for a fight, and then those guys, they like me there, you know. They say, oh, you can come here, I can get you house, I can get you food, and then you can live in Thailand, you have a good train here.
Under the wing of the prestigious Tiger Muay Thai camp, Wonderboy began his journey in mixed martial arts and cemented his reputation as a high-level striker.
If you've never seen Fabricio Andrade compete before, you're about to find out why they call him Wonderboy.
In my whole career, I always look for fight the best guys, you know? So when I see how good Choco Sato was, I was like, I want to fight this guy, you know? I know I can beat him.
He likes to give his opponents just different looks, not allow them to get comfortable, and just put a little bit different tempo behind these things. And that's one thing you're seeing. He can flurry, and then he can also go off his back foot. Andrade is a very talented striker.
Why not?
That works. Good elbow. Ah. That left elbow has been a treat the entire contest.
Fabricio Andrade!
I came here today to tell everyone that now you gotta watch me. I just take the number 2 contender, and I wanted the belt next.
after the Shoko Sato fight, like, people finally, like, start to realize, like, how good I were, you know?
The fast-rising Brazilian continued to dominate one's bantamweight division, crushing every opponent in front of him.
Beautiful one time. They almost folded him like origami.
You won't beat the avocado. It's like bling blow. Hey.
I am the uncrowned king, and everybody knows it. Everybody knows. For me, already, like, I think I'm so confident because I went through so much difficult stuff that this is not difficult anymore.
Generation icon, give me the title shot.
He doesn't deserve the title shot. He's not on my level.
I'm prepared to fight any of you guys. I can finish any of you guys, you know. And I think they feel it. They're scared, you know.
With a stunning 5-0 run in one, including three straight knockouts, Wonder Boy propelled himself to the top, earning a world title challenge against bantamweight king John Lineker.
John Lineker got no skills. He's just crazy. He just throw hands like a crazy guy. He do that with me, I'm gonna knee his belly so strong, he's not gonna breathe for 2 days. I'm a smarter fighter. He's smaller, he's a short guy. He's probably stronger, but he cannot touch me, you know? He won't be able to touch me, so it doesn't matter how strong he is. If he cannot touch me, that's not worth nothing, you know?
On October 21st, Wonder Boy finally gets his long-awaited title shot against Hands of Stone, John Lineker.
When you have the belt, you are the baddest guy on the division. You are the guy that everyone wants to fight. I feel like I'm the champion. I train like I'm the champion. I eat like I'm the champion. I do everything like I'm the champion already, you know? Be prepared, because I'm coming to knock you out.